Coming on to incubators, so these are a key equipment that has helped us manage the premature babies as well as we do now. It is essential for any preterm baby with thin skin which is at risk of insensible water loss. So even if you're not using the humidification function, the wind draught as well as radiant heat both are negative, so open care systems are not ideally suited. The incubator humidification is effective because it's a closed chamber and the relative humidity within that chamber can increase significantly, up to 90% in many cases. The air curtains, like in the air boost function in the giraffe, helps to increase the air circulation, so it causes an air boost curtain when you open the doors or the side doors or the windows. Side ports or the windows in the incubator. If you want to do a certain procedure or you want to examine the baby, you turn on the air boost function so the air doesn't escape outside or the outside air doesn't enter that easily because there is a faster airflow, particularly in these cases. The other important aspect is because of this air curtain, the humidity inside may not drop as quickly. When we have a giraffe or an advanced incubator of similar sort, they do have a radiant warmer mode, so you can receive the baby in the radiant warmer mode in the labor room. You can close the incubator and bring the baby. You can switch on the humidity even as you are moving the baby. So this is a big advantage. Many units often use the radiant warmer mode for procedures in the same babies. When it comes to the extreme preterm, obviously humidification is very important. Exposing them to radiant heat alone without humidity is quite damaging. So even if you are doing a procedure, try to learn to do it within the incubator as best as you can. It can be challenging. It needs some training, especially when it comes to asepsis and a sterile field and not to touch the sides and so on. You may need help. You may need an extra hand to give you things, but it does work. And I have done procedures through the incubator, umbilical lines, long lines and so on as well. So if you are unable to do it and you do need to open, consider using a plastic bag for the duration, because at least the local area the baby is under the warmer will have the increased relative humidity. It's the same principle as using the plastic bag in the labor room. And when you bring in such babies, if you're doing procedures in the warmer mode, don't remove the plastic bag till the procedures are done. You can expose the area that you need to do the procedure under. So these are illustrations of the giraffe incubator. I'm not advertising any brand, but this is quite a good piece of equipment we use. And obviously the panel is on the top part. Most of the older incubators have the panel on the side, and you have quite a few adjustments. So this is the air boost option that I mentioned. The fan speed is indicated here, and the skin mode versus the air mode, and if you want the radiant heater option. So humidity is reflected here, and you can go up to 90% humidity. This is the radiant warmer mode of the giraffe. This top will come down and it closes to become an incubator mode.